Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Every experience happens only in the mind. No experience happens in the world. No experience happens to the body. Everything is happening in the mind. Wisdom is in the mind. Delusion is in the mind. Achievement is in the mind and failure is in the mind. Good is in the mind. Bad is in the mind. Ego is in the mind. God is in the mind. Everything is only in the mind. And we have been taking care of everything in this world except the mind. See the fun? It is said, avichara kruto bandha vicharena nivartate. The bondage is on account of the incomplete thinking. Incomplete thinking is that I am very unfortunate. Now who is this I? I am unfortunate, agreed. But who is this I? So we come to know I is mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife. Now is this all that I am? See. So although we refer to I, but we don't refer to the complete I, the partial I, the incomplete I. See? And therefore, all the problems of life happen. Therefore, Atmabodha also is possible only if we start working on the mind. And what is working on the mind? Evam Atma, Atma Ranau. Dhyanam mathane satatam krute udita vagatir jwala sarva jnanin dhanam dhayet. Evam, in this manner, as we were told earlier, one has to keep on reflecting again and again. Nirguno nishkriyo nityo nirvikalpo niranjanaha nirvikaro nirakaro nitya muktosmi nirmalaha. This way, again and again, insist you are not finite. Mind cannot comprehend infinite. Mind can comprehend only the finite. For example, we can understand 1 minute, 1 hour, 1 year, 100 years, 200 years, 1,000 years, 20,000 years, 1,000,000 years. What happens? Mind has a limit, and the limit is creating the limited knowledge. Similarly, our eyes, they can see the colors and forms up to a particular limit. From the violet up to the red, vibgyor. Only the vibgyor spectrum of light alone is seen by the eyes, not beyond it. But then what happens? We take that is to be the ultimate and we start suffering. Therefore, when we thus reflect again and again, and this reflection is a non-stop continuous process. See, one example I'll tell you, and this is what you get when you are sitting quiet. Don't have to do meditation, just be yourself. And in that these things are revealed. Like the Vedanta student here so many times, Tanmatra. Tanmatra means that alone, nothing else. So what is the tanmatra of the space? We are told shabda, the sound. The shabda, sound only. But where we get lost? We get lost in the specific sounds. God's name should be chanted. You should not abuse. But both of them are only sounds. But we get influenced by the specific aspects associated with the sound. Tanmatra, therefore, Bhagavan says in Gita, Pranamaha Sarva Vedeshu, as much I am Omkar in all the Vedas, so also Shabdakhe, any sound is Paramatma. Meaning what? Give up all special things in your life. Tanmatra. Now what is the special things? I am mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, special things. I am man, woman, young, old, beautiful, awful, special things. I am Tamilian, Gujarati, Marathi, Bengali, special things. See? And we get lost in that specialities. Therefore, the real spiritual life begins when we understand this basic principle. This is what is called as churning of the knowledge. So, when we want to get the ghee out of the milk, if we say, I can't see the ghee in the milk, how can I take it out? No, you have to go through a process. So, first of all, we heat for some time, then allow it to cool some time, then add the starter, it becomes the yogurt, then it is churned, and then the butter comes out, then it is heated. This process is there. In the same manner, the churning of knowledge. I, the individual, and Paramatma, the absolute. Now connect them together by the churning rod of intellect and inquiry. This is the meaning. Evam Atma Aranau Dhyanam Mathane Satatam Krute. And this has to be satatam krute, again and again, keep on reflecting. This is what is called nididhyasan. Then what will happen? That sarva ajnana indanam dahet, all the wrong notions will be burnt away. The wrong notions are about ourselves, about the world, about God and about the spiritual practice. These wrong notions will be taken care of. Thereafter, Arunenaiva bodhena purvam santamase hadrute tataha avirbhaved atma swayam evamshamaniva. So like before the sunrise, there is a slowly arrival of the light, Aruna, in the same manner. When this knowledge starts taking place, the Aruna is, one start remaining cheerful and happy. The spiritual practice doesn't mean we become abnormal. But we are happy, we are no complaining, we are at home in every place, in every situation, with everyone. Like the water is common. So put in any pot, the water is comfortable. But the ice cubes, they are not common. They want their own shape. In this manner, Atma tu satatam praptaha apraptam vad avidyaya. So we don't have to gain the self. We have to allow the self to be revealed, and therefore we should not have that notion. When I will get the vision of God, you will not. You are divine. Discover this. Thereafter, sthanu prushavad bhrantya krita brahmane jivata. Like the post is mistaken to be a ghost, in the same manner, the absolute is mistaken to be the jiva, the soul. And when we inquire about, what is that ghost, we come to know it is the post, in the same manner. This is one of the biggest and the most important thing in Vedanta. In all other paths, they do not inquire about who is jiva. In yoga, in karma kanda, in upasana, in siddha marga, in Jainism, in Buddhism, they don't inquire what is the jiva, what is the soul. They don't inquire. And it is just told that you are a jiva. Now please tell me, what is the jiva? See? Like we are told God. Now what is God? We are told. Yes, this is God. Understood. What is jiva? The moment you start inquiry about the jiva, the same principle, ego, I am miserable, who are you? Inquire. Then you come to know that the one who is miserable, he never existed. So all our problems are only lack of inquiry. We have to find out where is the problem. So, tattva swarupanubhavat utpannam jnanamanjasa aham mameti cha jnanam badate digbhramadivat. Like we have the wrong notion about the directions in a new place, in the same manner, when we come to know our essential nature, then all the wrong notions about me and mine, they are completely erased. See, friends. And for that we don't have to do anything, only observe the world and learn from that. This example I gave you, after divorce, the girl becomes a widow or not. And when somebody dies, husband or wife dies, now after that person dies, the remaining one, who is he or she? He can neither be husband nor the wife, because the requirement is for a woman to be a wife, there has to be a husband. But when the husband has died, meaning what? Husband never die. It is a man who died. When divorce happens, husband doesn't die. Because he doesn't exist. With this wisdom, when we start living, you will see that our whole approach to life will change. So, aham mameti cha jnanam badhate. So, this wrong notion, aham and mama. Our wrong notion is, I am mother, father, brother, sister, etc. Then, I am man, woman, etc. Then, I am young, old, etc. Then I am successfully failure, etc. Who are you, man? Then we come to know all these are born after body identification. See, once you get into this mode of inquiring your experiences, your approach to life will change. This is what in Ashtavakra Gita beginning comes, that Janak ji had a nice lunch, and in the garden he was just sitting below the tree comfortably and had a nap for a few moments. And there he saw that he is a beggar and something happened, and one dog was chasing him and he fell down. And when he got up from the dream, then he asked this question, who am I? Is the king Janaka was dreaming that he is a beggar, or the beggar is dreaming that he is a king? Find out, who is this? Svakale satyavad bhati. When the dream goes on, nobody dreams the dream as imagination. That time it is a solid reality. Like this waking dream is a solid reality for us. During the dream, if somebody comes and tells you that this is a dream, come on, forget about it. Do you think we'll listen? Similarly, in this waking dream, if we tell you that this is a dream, Swamiji, okay, don't take food. See, Maharaj, it is so simple and straight. Therefore, what we have to practice now, be attentive. We have to practice that this waking experience is a dream. This is what is spiritual practice now. So what will happen? When we get out of the dream, the friends and enemies of the dream have no value. The achievement and failure of the dream has no value. See? So what will be the practice that this waking is a dream? When achievement and failure in the waking has no value. Friends and enemies in the waking have no value. Exactly, this is the spiritual practice Bhagavan Krishna tells in Bhagavad Gita. Sukha dukkhe samay krutva labha labhau jaya jayo tato yuddhaya yujjasva naivam papam avapsasi. See, my friends, again and again we have to remind ourselves of this. तो सम्यक विज्ञानवान योगी स्वात्मन्येव अखिलं जगत् एकं च सर्वमात्मानं ईक्षते ज्ञान चक्षुषा. नाउ हियर आई विल टेल यू समथिंग वेरी डीप, बी अटेंटिव. देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ स्टेटमेंट्स विच कम इन आवर स्क्रिप्चर्स, लाइक व्हाट वी हैव सीन. दिस वर्ल्ड इज एन इल्यूजन, ब्रह्म सत्यम जगन मिथ्या. द सेकंड थिंग कम्स, सर्वं खल्विदं ब्रह्म, एवरीथिंग इज ब्रह्मन. World is illusion, Brahman is real. World is Brahman, therefore Brahman is illusion. See how important it is. What does it mean? Now you take both the statements, and what should happen? When I take the world is an illusion, what will be my interaction with this illusory world? Like the rainbow we see, we know it is illusion. So what is our reaction with the illusory rainbow? We enjoy, but we don't desire. In the same manner, when we take this world as illusion, then we will enjoy, but we will not desire anything in this world. The second statement, everything is Brahman. Therefore, we are also included in that. It's not we are out of Brahman. And nobody has a desire for himself. Eyes cannot see themselves. Therefore, I cannot know myself. I cannot desire me. In both the cases, the net result is freedom from desires. When you take this world as an illusion, freedom from desire. When you take this world to be yourself, freedom from desire. Therefore, what is the spiritual practice? How simple it is. And what is the samsara? We constantly are struggling to fulfill our desires. And we have not learned how many desires we have fulfilled. Have we come to a point of fulfillment in life? No. See, friends, when we thus go deeper and deeper in the statements of the scriptures, then alone it is called as reflection nididhyasana. Otherwise, mechanically, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am not the body, I am not the mind. Like, you know, the story. There was an elderly bird in a forest, and he was telling the young birds, the hunter will come, he will spread the net, he will throw the grains, don't go there to take the grains, he will catch you and take you away. Now all of the birds started this Mahamantra. The hunter will come, he will spread the net and throw the grains. Don't go there, he will catch you. Again, the hunter will come. Continuously, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. And the hunter came. He spread the net. He threw the grains. All the baby birds, not listening to the elderly bird, came and sat there. The hunter collected all of them, put them on his back and started walking. And the chanting was going on. The hunter will come. The net will be spread. While giving the lecture, Aham Brahmasmi. After the lecture is over, Aham Brahmosmi. While giving the lecture, Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. After the lecture, Dakshina Nikalo. To whom are we cheating? See, my friends, simply mechanically chanting, Nakarmana na prajaya dhane na tyage na geya mridatva manaju. No meaning in that. And then Bhagavan has given us intellect, such a faculty, which can justify anything. Anything you do, you can justify that. Anything. Just imagine Rajiv Gandhi and the lady who killed him. Suppose they come and stand in front of you. Rajiv Gandhi will justify that he was killed was wrong. And she will justify that what she did was right. See, my friends, don't get carried away by the trap of this intellect. We have to transcend the intellect. And there the devotion comes. A devotee doesn't fall in the purview of law of karma. Because whatever is happening, Hari Ichcha, not my Ichcha, not my desire. In this manner, Samyak Vijnanavan Yogi, he who has thus correct, perfect understanding about the truth, then Swatmani Eva Akhilam Jagat Pashyan, then he comes to know, Mayeva Sakalam Jatam, Mai Sarvam Pradishtitam. If I is not there, my wife cannot exist. If I is not there, my children cannot be. If I is not there, my country cannot be. Everything is located, seated in this I. If I is not there, nothing can exist. Therefore, Atmai Vedam Jagat Sarvam, everything is nothing but the self. Now just see how simple it is. Colors and forms are nothing but the vision. If you have no vision, there are no colors and forms for you. Vision is nothing but the mind. If there is no mind behind the vision, the things are in front but we don't see them. So, objects are nothing but sense organs. Sense organs are nothing but mind. Mind is nothing but consciousness expressing, manifestation. Mind is not an individuality, it is a manifestation. Like light is a manifestation, it is not individuality. And therefore, whether the light is illuminating the Lord's idol or a toilet, it is not sin nor merit. See, friends, and if there is no electricity, no light, therefore, mind is nothing but expression of the pure conscious existence. Everything is me. But like the colors and forms cover the vision, sense organs cover the mind, mind covers the consciousness. Undo it. And the undoing is only one way. Do not give any value to all these things. Therefore, Atma Iva Idam Jagat Sarvam Atmano Anyanya Vidyate Mrudo Yadvat Ghata Adini Svatmanam Sarvamikshate. Like all the mud pots are nothing but the mud, in the same manner, everything is nothing but Paramatma. Jivan Muktastu Tadvidvan Purvopadhi Gunantyajel Satchidananda Rupatvad Bhaved Brahmar Kirtavata. In this manner, Jivan Muktaha, one attains freedom while living. Freedom from be attentive, freedom from I. World is never a problem. The objects in this world, they are not a problem. The sense organs by which we comprehend them, they are not a problem. Mind is not a problem. Problem is when we become enslaved by them. And when we come to discover that they are nothing but me, then Jivan Muktaha. So such a Jivan Mukta, Purva Upadhi Gunas Tajet. Be attentive. He will be living no more as the body, but he will be living through the body. He'll be living no more as somebody, but he will be living as nobody. One example I'll tell you. Some grihasthas, they take sannyas. Nothing wrong, very good. And after they take sannyas, they don't drop their past. They'll be writing, the military officers. After retirement also they write, that retired brigadier. You no more brigadier, but that upadhi we don't want to discard. Similarly, the grihastha, retired IAS officer, Swami Gadbadananda. Can there be a more cartoon than this? Sannyasa. See, unless we are able to know the truth clearly, Therefore, jivan muktastu tad vidvan. Therefore, you will come across, there are many very good military officers. One of my friend, he is a brigadier. He is now almost 80, 82. But he has no smell of the tightness of a military personnel. He is so simple. So I used to always play fool with him. I said, Brigadier Saab, when you are in the office, everybody coming saluting, cut, cut. Now you have to go here and there. He said, Swamiji, it has never attracted me. I was brigadier by mistake. So relax. How important it is. Therefore, be attentive. Such great jivan mukta persons, they are functioning through the body and no more working as the body. They are functioning through the mind, no more working as the mind. They are functioning through the intellect, no more becoming intellectuals. Functioning through the body is not a bondage. Suppose there is a ditch on the road and you see that your body is likely to fall. Therefore, you take a detour and protect yourself. It is not a sin. But when you take yourself to be the body and therefore you start hurting others, then the problem begins. See, friends. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is function through the upadhi. But don't come under the influence of any upadhi. See, friends. Therefore, Satchidananda Rupatvat Bhaved Brahmar Kitavata. He being of the nature of the blissful existence, like when you are constantly committed to something, that alone you become. Yoya Shraddha Sa Eva Saha. Be very attentive. When I consider one example, I'll tell you to make this point. This happened in Mattanjali, in near Ernakulam. I was staying in a Gujarati house. And there was a child. So I asked him, "Hey Gujju, what is your name?" Immediately he retorted, "I am not a Gujju." I said, "Chan, then who are you?" "I am a Lohana Kachi." Kachi also means underwear. I said, "Do you know how to tie the Kachi?" "I don't know." "Then who ties for you?" "Mommy." "Who are you?" "Kachi." "What is Lohana?" "I don't know." "Then who are you?" "I am Lohana Kachi." So this has gone so deep in his system. Is it not our story? I am a Gujarati, I am a Bengali. See? Gujarati is staying in Tamil Nadu for last 20 generations. They continue to be Gujarati. They never become Tamilian. Think, friends. Tamilians going and staying in Bombay for 100 generations, they are still Madrasi. They are not Maharashtrians. How simple it is. This is called as that we have taken ourselves to be this and we hold on to that. And there is no logic behind it. Similarly, we have taken that I am the body. Then there is no logic. And we continue to as a logic, body. Be attentive. Then we take ourselves to be husband, wife, brother, father, mother, sister, lucky, unlucky. And we hold on to that. Change your wrong notions. See, then we a little bit graduate from this and then we become jiva. Everybody says we are a jiva. And then we papo ham, papa karma ham, daan dharma karo, you will go to heaven. See? In the entry point in the heavens, there was one person fighting with the attendants. And Yamaraj said, "Hey, what is the problem? Why they are fighting? You are fighting." "No, this man, according to the records, he has given only 25 naya paisa as a charity donation. And he wants on the account of that first go to heaven. But according to our rules, he has to go first to hell because the whole life was horrible. And he is not listening. What should we do?" Yamaraj said, "Send him to me." He goes there. He said, "Yes, what is the problem?" "I have given 25 naya paisa. I want to go to heaven first." Yamaraj takes out 25 paisa, take and go. Once for all. See, friends. Therefore, yo yashraddha, I think I am a husband, you have to suffer. I think I am a man, you will be born and you will die. I think I am a soul, punarapi janaram, punarapi maranam. You think that you are divine, you are divine. Can there be more freedom than this? But it has gone so deep in our system. No, no, no. How I can be Brahman? No, no, no. I cannot be. See what happens? I don't remember anybody's names. So I had the Mahatmaji come here. Now they feel bad. Swami, don't call me Mahatma. Because it has gone so deep in their system that they are Papatma. Swami, you are making fun of us. Where we are Mahatma? Okay, you fool, come. Then they get disturbed. How come Swamiji also knows? See, friends. Then who are you? Yo yashraddha sa eva saha. So you insist again and again. This is real meditation. When you are sitting, don't waste too much of time. Only asana and all that. Do it for 5, 7, 10 minutes. That's it. Thereafter, insist what it is like being other than the body. Take this as a mantra. What it is like being other than the body. I am not telling you. I am not the body. I am not the body. Don't do that dumb thing. Work on what it is like being other than the body. See, you are not struggling. And to make this conviction, then we start working. We don't stop thinking. We start inquiring. Being other than the body means whatever are the attributes of the body, they are not my attributes. So what is the attribute of the body? Body has a shape. So being other than the body means what? No shape. So what is like being formless? And what is formless in our knowledge? The space is formless. Therefore, now we start playing. Space, space. The moment mind takes the formless as the object, the mind dissolves. Because mind cannot survive without forms. Formless mind is consciousness. Formless ice is water. This is what is meant here. Atat vyavritti jivan mikstustu tadvidvan purvopadi gunatajen sachidananda rupatvad bhaved brahmarakitavat. This is the meaning of this shloka. Tirtva mohar navam hatva ragad dveshadi rakshasan yogi shanti samayuktaha atma ramo virajate. Now such a great master. Tirtva mohar navam, the ocean of delusion is transcended. Hatva ragad dveshadi rakshasan, then all the rakshasas of ragad dvesha, likes and dislikes are killed. Then such a yogi, shanti samayuktaha, he has attained a peace which is beyond all the relativity. Atma Ramo Virajate, thus Lord Rama comes back to his own status. Tirtva Moharnavam, the ocean was crossed by Bhagwan Rama, that my peace, my shanti, my wife was taken by the Rakshasas. Who are the Rakshasas? Raga, Dvesha, likes and the dislikes. So, this Rama, who was deluded because of the Rakshasas, likes and dislikes, who have taken his wife, Shanti, Sita, then Hatva, he has destroyed the likes and dislikes. Then Shanti Samayuktaha, then he again got back his Sitaji, the peace. Then Atma Ramo Virajate, thereafter Rama ruled Ayodhya. Ayodhya, where there is no Yuddha, there is no fight, there is all peace. See, friends, Bhajya Nitya Sukha Saktim Hitva Atma Sukha Nirutaha Ghatastha Deepadvastha Svastaha Shvantara Iva Prakashate. So, Bhajya Anitya Sukha Saktim Hitva, giving up the searching for happiness in the outer world and discovering the bliss that one is, the state of such a master is Ghatastha Deepavat Svastaha, like a lamp kept in a pot which is undisturbed by the winds. In the same manner, Svantareva Prakashate, such a yogi attains perfect peace within. By then, Upadhisthopi Tadharmahi Aliptaha Vyomavan Munihi Sarvavid Mudha Vatishtet Asakto Vayuvacharet. So, Upadhisthaha Api, although living in the body, but he is no more living as the body. Although expressing through the eyes, but no more living as the eyes. Although functioning through the intellect or the mind, but no more influenced by the vagaries of the mind or the intellect. And such a Mahatma, Vyomavat, he is like the space. Space supports everything, but doesn't get influenced by anything. Such a one, sarvavit mudavattishte, such a wise person should live in this world like a fool. Be very attentive. Real spiritual evolution is when you drop all your special status. Being special is samsara. You have to drop everything. Nirvishesha, nirvikara, niralamba sthiti is Paramatma. Non-specific existence. We are all specific existence. Sa re ga ma pa, specific sounds. The fragrance of the agarbatti, the fragrance of the saints, and the dirty smell of the garbage. So smell with specific status. No. Give up all specific. This non-specific existence is our essential nature. Therefore, sarvavid vimudhavattishtet. Such wise people don't live here like wise, but they live like a fool. See? It is a folly to be wise among the fools. There were three persons. They were arguing with each other. And the fourth wise man was passing. So they called. You come and tell what happened. See, I am telling this is a snake. The other is telling this is a dry garland. The third is telling this is a crack in the soil. Now tell. What is the truth? We are not agreeing with each other. And the fourth person knew that it is a rope. If he will say all three of you are wrong, they will come together and kill this fellow. So what the wise man should do? I don't know. Go away. See, mudavaj. Therefore, I never entertain any question answer. Useless. In US it happened. One gentleman asked this question, Swamiji, And he was teaching Gita, imported from India, NRI father. And he said, Swamiji, how many verses are for the Dhritarashtra, Sanjay, Arjuna and Bhagavan Sri Krishna in Bhagavad Gita? I said, I don't know. This is the Maha Mantra. This mantra has protected me so many places. You don't have to answer every question of every fool. But we struggle. Nahi, iska aisa, who and I don't know. Over. Mudhavat chalet. Janan apihi medavi. Jadaval lokama chalet. See, friends. Therefore, sarvavid mudhavat tishtet asakto vahi vacharet. Like the air is no more attached to any place. Keeps on moving. Upadi vilayar vishno nirvishesham vishen munihim jale jalam yad vyomni tejas tejasi vayatha. In this manner, upadi vilayar nirvishesham muni. See what is I have been telling again and again. The real spiritual practice is we don't have to become vishesha. We don't have to become extraordinary. Remain ordinary. Like many people, you know, they have their own ways and it is not their fault because of Babaji's. So one person asked me in somebody's house, Swamiji, do you take food outside? I said, yes. But Mahatmas don't take food outside. How come you take food outside? I said, it is because of you. No, what did I do? I said, why do you call me Mahatma? You label me something and then you expect me to behave according to your label. I am not a Mahatma, I am a CH Atma, Chota Atma. See, friends, we have to drop all specialities. And all our life is a struggle. I want to prove something to somebody. Relax, relax. Somebody calls you, a person in Bombay is called, you are a fool, you are a murkha. He will get angry. In Maharashtra, everything is maha. If you call him murkha, he doesn't like. You call him maha murkha, then he's okay. Friends. Therefore, jadaval lokam acharet. Then, nirvishesham vishen munihi, this contemplative master becomes absolutely unclaimed. You don't have to prove anything to anybody. See, friends, if this knowledge is firmly rooted in us, we will never think in terms of making something great about our life. See? Just dissolve. Ocean can become the wave. Wave can never become the ocean. Wave disappears. See? Therefore, yallabhanna paro labho yasukhanna param sukam yajnana param jnanam tad brahmetyavadharayet. Having attained which, there is nothing more to be attained. Having attained the bliss, there is no more bliss. And having attained this knowledge, there is nothing more to be known. This is the Brahman and this is our essential nature. Such a person will never have any struggle in his life. He will be a counter through which Paramatma is expressing. Yadrushtvana param drushyam yadbhutvana punarbhavaha yajnyatvana param neyam tadbrahmetyavadharayet. That is the Brahman, having seen which nothing remains to be seen, having attained which nothing remains to be attained, having known which nothing remains to be known. Tirya gurdo madapurna satchidananda madvayam anantam nityamekam yat tadbrahmetyavadharaye. Thus, the truth is without any limitation of time, space and object. See? Space doesn't have north, east, west, south. Space doesn't have up and down. It is for us. It is the north, east, west and south. space is non-specific. Atadvyavritti rupena vedante lakshate advayam akhandanandam ekam yat tadbrahmetya vadarayet. Atadvyavritti rupena. I am not this, I am not this, I am not this. All that can be rejected, start rejecting. Be attentive. This is exactly what we do every day. Only thing we don't know, we are doing this. How do we go to sleep? Think about it. We go to sleep, first of all, we discard all our achievements and failures in the world. Then we discard all our possessions. Then we discard all our relations. Then we discard everything and come back in our room. Other rooms and everything is discarded. In our room also, we go below the quilt and we discard all the lights, everything. And ultimately, only one japa continues. I want to sleep. I want to sleep. I want to sleep. Till such time, I is putting efforts to fulfill the want, the sleep. Till then, sleep doesn't begin. The moment even the I, who was wanting to sleep, even he is dropped, the sleep begins even in the satsanga. And therefore, those people who sleep in satsanga, I like them the most. They already discarded the I. What for we are here? And others are struggling. Atma, Brahman, ka gaya, dekh lunga. Wherever there is a struggle, we are going the wrong way. Prayatna shaithilya, ananta samapattibhyam. When somebody struggles to hear because of the hardness of hearing, he will get tired quickly because he's struggling. Those who are struggling in life, they always talk about this only. No, I don't want to. I want to forget about it. Relax. Let the life be lived through. Who cares? And to attain this, a simple rule I'll tell you. Always remember, today is the last day of our life. Therefore, celebrate. Don't cry. Kal kya hoga? When you are not there, tomorrow will not be there. Enjoy. We are here for a celebration, not for a calibration. See? Therefore, this is what is called as the Brahman. Then, Tirya Gurdva Madhapurnam Satchidananda Madhvayam, only Paramatma alone is. Everything is only an appearance and no existence. Atadvyavritti Rupena, whatever we are not rejected, Vedante Lakshate Advayam. This is indicated by the Vedanta Shastra. Akhandananda rupasya tasyananda lavashritaha brahmadya taratamena bhavantyanandino lavaha. In Taittiriya Upanishad, Ananda Mimamsa comes. There Ananda Mimamsa is very beautiful. Just to try to calibrate the quantum of happiness. It cannot be, but just examples are given. If there is someone very young, healthy and intelligent and he has got a beautiful, intelligent, obedient wife, these are all imaginations. All these things do not exist. So, if such a person is ruling the whole world and he is the ultimate king of this world, what will be his happiness? That happiness is one unit of human happiness. Then such 100 units of human happiness is called as the Deva happiness. Then one unit of Deva happiness. Then 100 units of Deva happiness is called as the one unit of the Karma Deva happiness. It goes on adding. And in that it is included Brahmaji's happiness, Brihaspati's happiness, Indra's happiness. And when you cannot calculate further, how many, I cannot go more than 10,000. 1 followed by 0, 10, 2 zeros, 100, 3 zeros, 1000, 4 zeros, 10,000. After that, I get lost. Now here, so many hundred human happiness, one unit. Then 100 human happiness, that means 100 followed by 2 again zeros, 4 zeros. Then again 2 zeros. Then 8 zeros. My God, how many of them? In short, what is said, this infinite bliss transcends all the limitations of calculations. Because it is not created. Whatever is created is calculated. See? What is the size of your house? 340 square meter. What is the size of the space? Therefore, this is uncalculated happiness. So, brahmadya taratamena bhavantya andino lavaha tadyuktam akhilam vastu vivahara sadanvitaha tasmat sarvagatam brahma kshire sarpire vakile. This everything is existing in this reality. Therefore, everything is paramatma. Like the ghee is in the milk, in the same manner, Paramatma alone is the reality behind the total world of relative existence. And for that, the contemplation is Anandvam, Asthulam, Arasvam, Adirgam, Ajam, Avyayam, Arupam, Gunavarnakyam, Tad Brahmetya Vadharaye. To give up everything which can be known. Anu is small, Anandva is not small. Then Asthulam, Thula is gross, it is not gross, it is not small. All the contradictions are the places where the truth is hidden. One example I'll tell you. How to see the truth? Joy is experienced by me. So you are the experience. Misery is also experienced by me. Yes, you are the experiencer. So who are you? You are other than both joy and sorrows. Sound is experienced by me? Yes. Silence is experienced by me? Yes. Sound and silence, they are opposed to each other. But I am not opposed to anyone. Therefore, behind every contradiction, the truth is hidden. We get obsessed with these contradictions. Only peace. There should not be any disturbance. You will see in many ashrams, they have got this very noisy board everywhere. Keep silent, keep silent. And then there is a board outside. Meditation in progress. Take a detour. Don't enter. Why? There will be disturbance because they are already disturbed. See, friends, truth is unopposed. We are not opposed to anything or anybody. That is the ultimate. This is Tad Brahmetyam Dharaye. Yad Bhasa Bhasyate Arkadi. Yad Bhase Yastuna Bhasyate. Yena Sarva Midam Bhati Tad Brahmetyam Dharaye. That because of which everything is illumined, but that because that which cannot be illumined by anything, that is the reality. The every statement becomes meditation. Colors and forms are illuminated by the eyes. Eyes cannot be known by the colors and forms. The mind knows the sense organs. Sense organs cannot know the mind. The consciousness knows the mind. Mind cannot know the consciousness. Tad Brahmetya Vadharaye, recognize this is the reality. Waking comes, goes. Dream comes, goes. Deep sleep comes, goes. Samadhi begins, ends. We have never come, never gone. We can ask a question. Where is earth? Where is water? Where is fire? Where is air? We cannot ask a question. Where is space? Everything is in the space. Exactly the same way. waking comes and goes. Where from the clouds come and where the clouds go? They come from nowhere, they go nowhere. In the same manner, waking comes from nowhere, goes nowhere. Dream comes from nowhere, goes nowhere. Deep sleep comes from nowhere, goes nowhere. Samadhi begins and ends and goes nowhere. But I, the conscious space, Chidakasha, is ever the same. Tat Brahmetyavadharet, that is what is called as the ultimate truth. Then sarva swayam antar bahir vapya bhasayan nakhilam jagat brahma prakashate vannir taptaya ayasa pindavata. That which is both inside and outside. We may call it, like this is another very simple theme. This small container, inside the container there are tablets. Outside the container there are no tablets. Now this container is inside the pocket. Container is not outside the pocket. Then this shirt is inside the hall. Shirt is not outside the hall. Meaning, till such time the concept of in and out is valid, samsara will continue to be. In deep sleep, we are inside the body or outside the body. We are inside the room or outside the room. We are in Tamil Nadu or in Bengal. When there is a reference, then only in and out can happen. See, in this manner, the more we contemplate, we come to know all these things are only born out of identification with the body. So, jagat vilakshanam brahma, brahmanonyanna kinchana, brahmad anyad bhati chen mithya yatha marumadishika. Therefore, everything is brahman and the world is totally different and brahman is totally different. World appears, brahman is the reality. Like the wrinkles appear on the lungi, but lungi is the reality. In the same manner, if the wrinkles are other than the cloth, then it is a dust, it is not the wrinkle. Shruyate drushyate yadyat brahmano anyanna tad bhavet tatva jnanat tad brahma sachidanandam advayam. Whatever is heard, seen, everything is nothing but Paramatma, and this is ultimate knowledge. And this is what has to be accepted. Everything comes and goes. We are never come and gone anywhere. Like the space doesn't come and go anywhere. Space is ever the same. There cannot be any efforts involved. The whole spiritual life is a process of undoing. It is not doing something. It is not that we have to become divine. We have to unbecome whatever we have become. We have become mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife. Unbecome. We have become man, woman, young, old, beautiful, awful. Unbecome. We have become a soul, papoham, papa karma, unbecome. And you come to a point where there is no becoming. Therefore, there is no becoming and therefore no be going. This eternal truth is our essential nature. Sarvagam satchidatmanam jnana chakshur nirikshate ajnana chakshur naikshetva bhasvantam bhanumandavata. Jnana chakshu, he who has this vision of wisdom, he alone will be able to understand and experience this. The ignorant will never understand, like a blind person can never see the sun. Although the sun is there, but because he is blind, he cannot see. In the same manner, Those who are blind to this worldly relativity as real, they can never know the truth. Sharavanadivir upteho Sharavanadivi uddipta jnanagni paritapitaha jiva sarva malanmukta swarnavadyotade swayam. By the fire gained through the Shravan Manan Nididhyasana, this jiva becomes absolutely pure, immaculate, like the gold is heated in the fire, all impurities burned, and inherent shining of the gold surfaces. Exactly the same way, the inherent divinity in us will be brought out when all the wrong notions are burnt away in the fire of Shravan Manan, etc. Vrudakashodito yatma bodhabhanustamopar sarvavyapi sarvadhari bhati bhasayate kilam. So vrudakashodito atma, therefore the atma, the self, is our essential nature. See, hrudaya means harati yat tadvadayam, that which withdraws everything is hrudaya. So everything comes in me, goes out of me. Nothing is created, nothing is born. It's only the process of manifestation, unmanifested. In the second chapter, Bhagavan uses these terms. Avyaktadini bhutani vyakta madhyani bharata avyakta nidhananeva tatrakapari devana. All the waves are manifesting, again they go back. So when the waves are born, we don't celebrate happy birthday to waves. And when the waves die, we don't mourn. Because waves are only manifestation and manifestation. Exactly the same way. Identification with the body, somebody is manifested. Disidentification with the body, somebody has become unmanifest. Constantly going on. Our bodies are separate. Our waking experiences are separate. Our subtle bodies are separate. Our subtle body experiences are separate. But our causal body is one. Your causal body, my causal body are not separate. Like ocean is common for all the waves. Exactly the same way. We all manifest, unmanifest. Manifest, unmanifest. Nothing happens to us. Tad brahmetiva dharayet, that is our essential nature. Digdesha kala dhanapeksha sarvagam shitadi runnitya sukam niranjanam yasvatmatirtham bhajate vinishkriyaha sar sarvavis sarvagato amrto bhavet. In this manner, he who is able to invoke in the holy shrine of the self in his heart shitadi runnitya sukam niranjanam, beyond the heat and cold, ever blissful and without any impurity of relativity, yaha svatma tirtham bhajate, he who is thus worshipping the divine in his own heart as his essential self, vinishkriyaha, without any efforts involved, sa sarvavit, he alone has known everything, he alone has attained everything. With this, he attains Atmabodha and our satsanga is over. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.